Today, we're going to look at four ways in which you can use compound paths in your workflow when working in Adobe Illustrator. After today's video, you should have a perfectly clear understanding of compound paths and why they're so useful. Something else useful to you as a graphic designer is Skillshare, which hosts over 25,000 classes throughout the entirety of the online learning community. You can learn useful techniques and skills for graphic design, logo design, and much, much more. Skillshare is also super affordable, but today I have a special offer for the first 500 people who sign up to Skillshare, as they will receive a free trial of Skillshare Premium for 2 months. Check out Skillshare, link down below. What exactly is a compound path? Now, a compound path consists of two or more vector paths that intersect somewhere along the lines. No matter how many components make up a compound path, they all act as one individual unit. If you try to select separate paths that make up the compound path with the selection tool, then the whole compound path will be selected. However, you can select and move components within the path using the group selection tool or the direct selection tool. So essentially, it is a non-destructive way to add an effect or an operation to a group of shapes in Adobe Illustrator. So when do we actually need to use a compound path in our workflow? For the first example, we have three different circles here, each of which have the same gradient. Now I want to add the gradient spread across the entire selection of shapes, so I might actually come and unite them in the Pathfinder window. This doesn't result in the desired effect, and even if we did achieve it, the three circles are now one united vector object, and that is a destructive workflow. So instead, we can make a compound path, and hey presto, the gradient is spread across the entire selection. That's not the only neat aspect of the compound path. The compound path also allows us to take the direct selection tool and carefully pick the center of the circle to manipulate it. You will notice that the gradient stays relative to the orientation of the circles, which is a neat function of the compound path in Illustrator. We can then of course adjust the gradient in the gradient window, but also we have the ability to add other design elements into the compound path, and Illustrator is going to keep the gradient relative throughout. Now, how awesome is that? The second useful function of the compound path is heavily based around non-destructive workflow. When working in Photoshop or Illustrator, it's helpful to perform functions and operations to where we can make edits and changes at a later date. So if I want to cut out these two circles into the square, I can use the minus front option in the Pathfinder window. However, once this has been done, it is not easy to edit the cutout sections or even revert back to the original. So instead, let's create a compound path, because I can then use the direct selection tool to manipulate and to move the cutout circles. This in itself is very handy, but I can also revert back and release the compound path like so. So I have two more situations in today's video where the compound function is useful for your graphic design workflow. The third point in today's tutorial is a kind of extension and upgrade on the previous point. Again, working in the Pathfinder window, we can use the minus front option to cut out shapes into other shapes, which you already know. However, if we want to make a quick compound path, we can use the minus front option, but whilst doing it, hold down the Alt or the Option key. Now the cutout is a compound path, open for manipulation and edits whenever we need to make them. The last function of a compound path in today's Illustrator tutorial is based around text. Now often in Illustrator, we need to convert the text to a compound path to add certain effects, but also to make sure it's in a non-destructive workflow, as we can edit the text and the wording later. One of those effects is using a clipping mask on the text itself, utilizing the shapes behind. So, like before, turn the text into a compound path like so, and then place it over the shapes and go ahead and apply a clipping mask. Once the clipping mask has been applied, like all of the other compound applications, we can then move the text as well as edit the wording itself, while the effect remains the same throughout. Now I hope you better understand the compound path function in Adobe Illustrator. Today's video is somewhat of a re-upload, I just expanded on it a little bit more. Now remember, if you want to join the Skillshare community of over 7 million creators, check out Skillshare down in the description box below, where the first 500 people to sign up are going to receive 2 months free of Skillshare Premium. Like and share my videos on social media, and have a great day everybody, and until next time, design your future today. Peace.